his hunger for power, he was ready to kill that person. So that's why something so horrifyingly incomprehensible, like a father wanting to kill one's own child, that can become entirely possible if one becomes obsessed with one value. So for him, it was not that he had no values. Nobody can have no values. Everybody has some values. But whether the values are divine values or demoniac values. That's the question. So his value was, I want power. Everybody should bow down to me. And if my own son is not ready to bow down to me, I will destroy that person. So there is a dark side within every one of us. And to the extent we recognize that this dark side, if it is not controlled, if it is not regulated, it can darken my entire life. So the scriptures often provide these two trajectories. Like we have Ram and Ravan. We have the Pandavas and the Kauravas. We have Prahlad and Hiranyakashipu. Now often when the scriptures depict the story, they depict characters in their extremes. So Prahlad's level of devotion might seem incomprehensible for us. How can someone face against the whole world? Earlier I said that he was completely alone, standing for principles that would even cost him his life. So the divine side is depicted in an extreme way in this story. But conversely, the demoniac side is also depicted in an extreme level in this story. Now usually, we are neither that demoniac nor are we that divine. But the point is that by gradual accumulation of our choices, if we keep doing one wrong thing, one wrong thing, one wrong thing, the snow pebble can become a snow boulder, and we might end up doing things which we never thought we would. So Hiranyakashipu is not present in a full-blown form within us, but in an infinite form, that Hiranyakashipu is also there. And recognizing its presence helps us to stay on guard. I don't want to get carried away by this. But Prahlad, so I was talking earlier about foolishness and foolhardiness. Fearlessness and foolhardiness. So Prahlad was fearless, but in some cases it can appear that he's foolhardy. When his father asked him, what did you learn at school? Now for him, the school, this whole educational system was just a tool for ideological indoctrination. What is that? Everybody should learn the glory of Hiranyakashipu. That is all that you have to learn. What did you learn in school? And Prahlad gave answers which outraged his father. He said, oh, I have learned the best thing is that you should be a devotee of Vishnu. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasyam Sakhyam Atma Nivedanam Iti Pumsar Pita Vishnu Bhaktischena Nav Lakshana Kriyeta Bhagvatyata Tanmanyedita Maktamam. This is that being devoted to Vishnu is the best thing that I've learned. He got angry at that time. So once this happened, and he sent his back to his teacher and told him to teach him properly. Again happened, he got extremely angry and decided to kill him. And he couldn't kill him at all. None of his ways to try to kill him worked. And then he asked Prahlad, what is the source of your power? So now Prahlad's answer can seem like deliberately provocative. What does he say? He says, the source of my power is also the source of your power and also the source of your power. Because my power comes from this, your power is coming from Brahma, but the source of my power is the source of the power of Brahma also. Now, why is he provoking like this? His point is not to provoke, his point is to educate. So some people think, so Hiranyakashipu had this vision of competitive hierarchy. There is a pecking order and I have got nearly to the top of the pecking order.
Now one step above is Vishnu. Okay, just knock off Vishnu, then I'll get to the top. So some people think that there's a hierarchy of beings and God is the best of all beings. So if I can become more powerful, like say in tennis or sports, now there is a player who is number one, number two, number three. The number five player keeps performing better and better, they will become number one. So Hiranyakashipu had that idea, I'll become more and more and more powerful, I'll become number one, I'll become God. But Prahlad wanted to free Hiranyakashipu from that notion. God is not just the best of all beings. God is the basis of all being. God is the basis of all being. God exists in a category different from everyone else. Whatever power anyone has, all that power comes from God. That's why if you see the sequence of verses, after that what he says is that don't think of Vishnu as your enemy. You have no enemy except your own uncontrolled and misguided mind, because of which you are thinking Vishnu to be your enemy. So Vishnu is not the enemy of anyone. So Prahlad, his courage of conviction, his utter fearlessness in even the presence of Hiranyakashipu, it came because he did not see Hiranyakashipu as an independent source of power. Hiranyakashipu's power is also coming from Vishnu. So if Vishnu wants me to die, then Hiranyakashipu's weapons will hurt me. But if Vishnu does not want me to die, Hiranyakashipu's weapons will not hurt me. And that's why it's in the first canto, when Arjuna is offering prayers, he is saying, Krishna, in the Kurukshetra war, you protected me just as you protected Prahlad. Narhari, no vispushyam, narhari dasyam. Just as no weapons could hurt Prahlad, no weapons could hurt me. Now, externally speaking, you could say Prahlad and Arjuna are exactly opposite. Prahlad never raised a single weapon. No matter how many weapons were hurled at him, Prahlad's closed eyes, smaranam, he embodies, he represents the bhakti form of devotion. In contrast, Arjun is famous as the wielder of the Gandiva, who was a champion archer. So Arjun was vigorously fighting against his opponents, whereas Prahlad was doing nothing to fight against his opponents. So externally the two might appear to be entirely different. But internally, both of them understood that all power came from Krishna. So in that particular situation, Krishna chose to not give Prahlad any power to fight against his opponents. But Prahlad was protected. Arjun had been given phenomenal power to fight against his opponents. But Arjun is acknowledging that I was protected not by my power, O Lord, I was protected by your power. So Prahlad's devotion is exemplary, because he is a model of having complete conviction that all power, my power as well as others' power, comes from the Lord. And Arjuna also had that conviction. So sometimes we may have to practice bhakti like Prahlad. Whatever happens, I accept it. Sometimes we practice bhakti like Arjuna, fighting against the bad things that are happening in life. But the important thing is to understand that our power is not our power. Now some people say that I have many hidden talents. The problem is they are hidden even from me. So what is happening over there is we want to think that I have a lot of powers, but I don't know what those powers are. The fact is whatever talents we have which are known and whatever talents we have which we may not know, all of them come from the Lord. And that is the example of devotion that Prahlad demonstrates. And eventually, when Hiranyakashipu comes, when Lord Narasimhadev comes, And Lord Narasimhadev delivers Hiranyakashipu. At that time, there is a Bhagavatam commentator, Vamshidhar. He asks this question that how is the Lord equal to everyone? Hiranyakashipu was killed. Prahlad was blessed. So is God really equal to everyone? So he says, God is equal to everyone. But God is also reciprocal. This, he was equal in the sense that both Hiranyakashipu and Prahlad, both of them got to be on the lap of Hiranyakashipu, of Narasimha. Both of them got to be on the lap. But what happened on the lap was very different. So what happened? We have a Bhaktivedanta hospital in India where in the operation theater they have a picture of Narasimhadev. So when one person had come there, he says, what is that picture? So that is the original operation. Oh, really? What happened in that operation? Operation successful, patient liberated. So what happened over there to Hiranyakashipu was different because his attitude was different. The Lord reciprocates. The Lord is equal to everyone in the sense that he gives equal reciprocity towards everyone. As we approach him, he reciprocates. So for us, we may not face challenges like Prahlad had to face. But whatever small challenges we are facing, if we determine that I will stay fixed in my bhakti, I'll stay fixed in my bhakti, then gradually what applies to the negative tendencies also applies to the positive tendencies. Just as our devotion right now might like this snow pebble. But if we keep practicing bhakti steadily, our devotion can also become like a snowball and a snowball. If you keep choosing Krishna in small, small, small ways, all of us may have difficult situations where practicing our bhakti might also seem very difficult. But within whatever situation we are in, if we strive to do the right thing, we strive to serve the Lord to the best of our capacity, then we can't have the power of a snowboulder, but we can have the power of a snowball. What we can do if we do that,